Take a moment right here, feeling like it's out gear, driving towards the sun with a rose and a gun. Feel the wind in my hair.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Brooke here. If you're new, then hi, I'm Brooke, and I have a giveaway on my last video, so go enter that so you have a chance at winning some cool makeup products. But anyways, today I have a Valentine's makeup look. It's a halo eye. I did like some really pretty like purple, pinky, orangey, brown colors, and then like a pop of pink shimmer in the middle. I did some winged liner, really bronzy and glowy. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I had a lot of fun with it, and I cannot wait to celebrate Valentine's Day with my boyfriend. I hope you guys are excited for Valentine's Day too, and excited about this look. You can wear it wherever you want. You can wear it if you're just with your friends or with your boyfriend or your family or whatever, or if you just want to play and recreate this look. I hope that you like it, and let's get into this tutorial because I'm excited. I hope you are. Okay guys, so let's go ahead and get started with this Valentine's look. I'm gonna start by prepping my skin. This is something that I've been like super into lately, is just making sure that my skin is like prepped really well, because I feel like it makes a huge difference whenever I put my foundation and everything on. So that's what I'm gonna be doing first. And I'm gonna start by putting on this Sonia Kashuk Radiant Boost Oil. I've spilt this thing like 100 times. And so the bottle's like half empty, but it lasts you such a long time. It's like $14 and I really, really like it. It hasn't broken me out or anything like that. And the squirter is kind of like not very subtle, so I kind of just like to barely squeeze it and then kind of rub it on my face, because this thing will like squirt out at you. I don't necessarily recommend doing this if you have oily skin, but I do have super dry skin, so that is why I'm going to be applying this oil. Okay, next, I'm going to spray my face with some of this Pixi Glow Mist. I love this stuff, but the squirter on mine is like super janky. It squirts out in like a straight shot, so I have to like... It was a mist when I first got it, but like, I don't know if the squirter got clogged or what, because now it just squirts out in a straight line. And last, I'm going to spray my face with this NYX Dewy Finish Setting Spray. You can spray this before or after your makeup. I like to spray it before and sometimes after too, but today I'm going to be spraying it before. Now that I feel like I've got my skin prepped really well, I'm going to go ahead and do my eyes first, and I'm going to be using tape so that I get like a really sharp line, because that's just the look that I'm kind of in the mood to go for today. I keep looking at myself in the camera and I'm so pale, it's like insane. I look like a ghost on camera. I haven't self-tanned in forever because I'm lazy, but I really need to. Okay. Ooh, I made this piece of tape really long. Okay, so I wanted to zoom you guys in so you can get a better look at what I'm doing on my eyes, and I might zoom you in even a little bit more, but for now I'm just gonna prime my eyes. For primer, I'm gonna be using the Urban Decay eyeshadow primer in the shade Eden. I received a few samples of this and that is what I'm gonna be using today. I do really like this. In comparison to my Too Faced Shadow Insurance Primer, I think I might like this one a little bit more, because it does add a little bit more coverage, cancels out the veins and everything a little bit more, which once I have my eyeshadow and stuff on, you really can't see anyways, but I do like the coverage that this one provides. So after I've got that eye primer on, I'm just gonna go in with any translucent powder. I'm gonna be using this first shade from my Kat Von D palette. It's not a translucent powder, it's a skin color powder. And I'm just going to set my eyeshadow primer with it. This is just gonna help everything go on smoother, the eyeshadows to blend better, because eyeshadow primer does have like a tacky consistency. So you don't wanna put powders right up against that you're gonna be blending out, because they're not gonna blend out very well. For the eyes today, I'm going to be jumping back and forth between the Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette. I think these colors in here are just gorgeous and perfect for Valentine's Day. And then I'm also going to be going on to my Makeup Geek eyeshadows as well. I'm going to go in with my Morphe blending brush, the M441 first. And I'm going to go in the crease. And I'm going to start out with Golden Ochre in the Anastasia palette. It's just a really light color. Honestly, probably too light for a transition shade, but I like to start really light and work my way up because it allows for your eyeshadow to look really blended. The next shade I'm going to go in with is Burnt Orange in the Anastasia palette. And I'm just using that same brush and I'm using really light circular blending motions right in my crease. Next, I'm going to go in with the color Sidekick from Makeup Geek. And it looks like this. It's just a really nice reddish brown color, but not too dark. And I'm going to switch over to my M433 brush from Morphe. It's just a little bit more tapered and thin versus big and fluffy, but it is still a nice fluffy blending brush. I'm just going to bring this down a little bit lower in the crease. Really light motions back and forth. Next, I'm going to go in with Tuscan Sun by Makeup Geek, which is just a really light pinky color. And I'm using my first brush, the M441, and I'm going to just blend that into the crease with all those other colors. My boyfriend is not even going to be here for Valentine's Day. I don't want to talk about it. No, but really, he's going to be in St. Louis. But whenever he comes in town, we're going to celebrate, so I'm excited. I'm going to go in with Love Letter from the Anastasia palette and my M433 brush. In case you can't tell, these two brushes are like my ride or die. I really want this to be focused like more on the outer corner over here. So I'm going to start out here and then gradually, very lightly, flicking it inward. Even though I'm sad that Clark won't be here, I'm excited because I'm probably going to visit St. Louis for my birthday, since he'll probably be there and not be able to come home. I think I'm going to fly there and visit, and I think that'll be so fun. We'll like go sightseeing and eat really good food and stuff like that, so I'm excited. Do any of you have any New Year's resolutions that you're still sticking with? I tend to make my New Year's resolution every year. I'm just blending with that first brush, blending everything together. But I tend to make my New Year's resolution every year is to like get in shape. But this year I was like, you know what? That's not going to be my New Year's resolution because I never actually do it. So my New Year's resolution this year is to be vegan. It's something I've always been kind of interested in. And so far it's going pretty good. I don't really miss meat that much. I do miss cheese and like dairy products though, but it's not that bad. I haven't ventured out like a whole lot and gotten like the day of cheese and stuff like that. I know they have like cheese pizza and I really want to try it. But I got a pizza the other day from this place called Loopy's here. And I just got their vegan gluten-free crust with marinara. And then I got like roasted garlic, avocado, sun-dried tomatoes, spinach, and red onions on it, and it was so good. Oh my gosh, it was so good. So yeah, I just got the marinara and the vegetables, and it was really good. Honestly, I just feel like guilty more than anything, like making people cater me. Like, I went to my boyfriend's last night, and his mom was going to get us all out back, and I had to like make a super complicated order. Like, I want this without this, and I want a salad, take away this and add this. And it's just, when you eat out, it's a lot of taking away and adding and like building your own food. So it's been kind of interesting. But it helps you get out there and try new things, and I've really been liking it so far. Next, I'm going to go into Red Ochre in the Anastasia palette, and I'm using my Morphe E17 brush, and I'm going to put this down here on my outer lid. And I'm going to apply that to the inner lid as well because I'm going to do a halo eye today. So just putting this on the very inner corner of my eye. and kind of blending above the middle. I'm kind of leaving this blank. Blending above. And between each step, I'm pretty much just taking this first blending brush and blending everything out in the crease. Next, I'm going to go into Cabin Fever from Makeup Geek. It's just a really nice reddish brown, but it's a little bit darker than Sidekick that we went into earlier. And I'm going to apply that in the same places that I applied Love Letter from the Anastasia palette. This is just going to deepen it up a little bit. After I've applied that to my outer and inner corners, I'm going to go even darker. And I'm going to go into Cypress Umber right here in the Anastasia palette. And I'm going to use that same brush and pack it on. If you guys want to see the best halo eye you've ever seen in your life, go to Tina Halata's channel. She's literally 15 and she is such an amazing makeup artist, and she has the best halo eyes I've ever seen in my entire life. Like, so good. So I'm going to take a little bit more of Golden Ochre onto my Morphe M433 brush, and I'm going to blend the brown into the crease with that color. Then I'm going to go in to Love Letter again and use that same brush and blend a little bit more. And I took a little bit more Red Ochre as well on my brush, and I'm blending this outer corner just a little bit. And then lastly, taking that first blending brush and blending that all together in the crease very lightly. Okay, now moving on to what we're going to put on the center of the lid. I'm going to take some more of that eyeshadow primer, just taking it on this flat concealer brush, and I'm going to pop that in the very center of my lid. Okay, so for this, it's a little bit different. We're not going to be setting it with a powder like we did for the other eyeshadows, because we're going to be putting a shimmer on the center, and we really want it to stick to that primer, so you don't need to set it first with a translucent or skin tone powder. And I'm just going to press that right on top of where I put that primer. Wow. Do you see that pigment though? Wow. That is stunning. If you wear this on a date or out with your friends, wherever or whatever you're doing for Valentine's Day, just know that everyone is going to understand how amazing your eyeshadow is going to look. Like, everyone is going to be like, wow. Okay, so we don't want just like a straight stripe down the middle of the eyelid. That's kind of the idea of a halo eye, but I'm gonna blend those darker colors in on the sides of it. And the color I'm going to use to do that is going to be Red Ochre from the Anastasia palette. Just using my E17 from Morphe and very lightly, like, dabbing it in. And next, I'm going to take my Morphe 321 brush and blend right up here, right above that pink shimmer shade. I'm going to be using the NYX Liquid Black Liner. And let's wing it out. That was like insanely difficult, and I'm literally one of those people that like draws my curve and then connects it down and fills it in, and no issue. Like, whew. These eyelash extensions are testing my eyeliner skills. Okay, so I've zoomed you out a little bit, and we're gonna move on to primer and the paste and all that. And I'm gonna start off with this NYX Hydratouch primer. This has been my go-to lately. Honestly, I recommend this for any skin type because oily skin, a lot of times the reason your skin is oily is to make up for the lack of oils and dryness that you have. And hydration is always good for your skin. And I really like this one because it's not super thick and goopy and feels like it's gonna clog your pores. It's like a gel-like texture and it's nice and cooling and just, it's really nice. I really recommend it. And then I'm gonna go in with the NYX Pore Filler as well. I really like this because it's a lot like the Benefit Professional, but it's not $30. You feel me? And I'm just gonna put this on my T-zone where my pores are huge. For a foundation, I'm gonna go in with my Anastasia Beverly Hills foundation stick. I'm in the color Beige, just for reference. Next, I'm going to go in with my Tarte Shape Tape in the color Light Medium. And I'm going to put just a little bit of my NYX HD Concealer in the shade 02. And add this underneath the eyes because I want it to be a little bit brighter. Next, I'm going to go into something that I've been obsessed with. It is the Wet n Wild Contour Cushion. This is like the most genius idea ever. It's like a cream bronzer contour and in a cushion. It's just such a good idea because you don't have to use a stick and then blend it out. You can just use like a foundation brush and it's just so, oh my gosh, I just love it. And it's so cheap. I really recommend trying this out, you guys. I promise you will not be disappointed. I just take my Sonia Kashuk number 130 brush and I dip it into the cushion and then I use it as my bronzer. I'm going to go into this Butter London cream blush in the shade Tiddly, and it's just a really pretty peachy pink color. And I'm going to use this Real Techniques sponge and just dab it into the blush and then dab it onto my cheeks. Next, I'm going to go into my Sephora Liquid Illuminizing Drops, and these are in the shade Morning Light. I'm going to just put some dots where I'm going to apply my highlight. I'm going to set it with my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. Next, I'm going to jump back into this Shade and Light palette, and I'm going to go in with just this e.l.f. like tapered fluffy brush and use these two shades right here. As you can tell, they're my favorite because they're both on pan, and set the under eye area. Then I'm going to go in and bronze with my Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. I love this stuff. Every time I use it on somebody, they're like, oh my gosh, what is that smell? I'm like, it's the bronzer. Isn't it amazing? Just bronzy, bronzy, bronze. Then I'm going to go in with contour, and I'm going to use this first contour shade from this Kat Von D palette. And then for blush, I'm using this Wet n Wild Color Icon Blush in the shade Pearlescent Pink. Okay, now let's move on to the lower lash line. And I'm going to go into the Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette. Go into this burnt orange. And blend that on the lower lash line. Next, I'm going to go in to Red Ochre, and I'm going to mix it a little bit with the Cypress Umber. And a little bit of Love Letter as well. Now comes my favorite part of the makeup, where I soak my face with my MAC Charged Water Skin Hydrating Mist. And I literally just sprayed this all over the face, and every product just sinks into the skin and looks so much more skin-like. I love it so much. I'm going to go in with my Laura Geller Gilded Honey Highlight. And I'm going to apply that everywhere I applied that cream highlighter. I like to just kind of blend it over my brow, and it is my brow highlight pretty much. I'm going to go in with my NYX Micro Brows Pencil in the shade Taupe. You guys have seen me do this like 100 times, so I'm going to just skip through brows on camera, and then I'll come back to you and we'll do the lips. Okay, so I just filled in my brows, but I wanted to come back real quick and talk about something that I've been using lately, because you know I normally use my NYX Tinted Brow Mascara, which I still love, but I discovered this new product by Maybelline. It's the Brow Precise Fiber Volumizer, and I've been obsessed with it. I have the color Blonde, and I've been using the brown shade on a lot of my clients, and I've just loved it so much. It is so good. It has like little fiber hairs in it, and it really sets the brow and like volumizes them and allows the hairs to be seen. So I was going to use this on camera and tell you guys about it. So now I'm going to put some mascara on my lower lash line, and I'm going to be using the Pixi by Petra Lower Mascara. Guys, so now let's move on to lips. Yeah, I'm going to be using the Jordana Sweet Cream Matte Liquid Lip Color in the shade Buttercream Frosting. And I'm going to be using the Kylie Cosmetics Lip Liner in the shade Exposed. Okay, I'm going to put my Laura Geller Gilded Honey on my inner corner. Okay guys, so this is the completed look. I really like the way that it turned out. I love the lip with these eyes. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I'm so excited for Valentine's Day. Well, not the actual day, but to celebrate Valentine's Day with my boyfriend. Yeah, on Valentine's Day, I'll probably go see the 50 Shades Darker movie with some friends. So yeah, thank you for watching, and don't forget to enter my giveaway. It's my previous video. Thank you so much for everything that you do by supporting me. It means so much. So that is why I really wanted to do this giveaway. I love you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye. Wanna be on the beat, trying hard to be someone else.